What is up, guys? Welcome to Pentatonix Tuesday. Today, we're going to be taking a look at episode 7 of the 2014 PT Experience entitled Trying New Things. I don't know where they are. Obviously, it's an American tour. I don't know whereabouts in America they are where they would be trying new things. They're from the South, so let's go ahead and guess somewhere north. But the American tour, though, is in full swing. They just finished up, I think it was in Chicago, and they're switching things around. They're really everything. It doesn't matter if it's an arrangement or the tour itself. It's ever-changing, and it's so interesting to see that process happen. So, yeah, I'm really excited. So thanks again, guys, so much for watching. Let's go ahead and get into episode 7.
Oh my God, what are they doing at the Mall of America?
Oh.
A Camp Snoopy performance? That's so cool. Oh my God, 2014, where was I living? Oh man! That's so awesome.
Everybody was loving during the performance.
It was a perfect set, perfect amount of time. Yeah. Everyone was so nice. I love it.
Yeah. Now, actually, another matter is I'm trying to text this girl and I have literally no idea what to say.
Oh no!
Don't worry. Are you trying to get some?
No.
It's okay. We can help you.
What are my intentions?
Is Kevin really about to hook up with a girl from Minneapolis?
Yeah, Kevin is a classy.
Exactly, man.
I'm a classy homie. So we just finished our Mall of America performance, and I've been kind of slightly talking to this girl, and I realize I need a little bit of help. I asked her, by the way, didn't I see you at the show? And she goes, yes, you get an A for good memory. However, you made me repeat my question, so you get a C for listening.
Ooh, I like her. She's nice. Well, then say, okay, maybe I deserve a C, but don't worry. Can I earn some extra credit?
Yeah.
Oh.
That feels like real forward, though.
No, just don't put a winky face.
Yeah, but she had a big
Just don't put a winky face.
She's being cute, and you're like playing the game.
No, I like this whole like school metaphor.
Yeah, because
it works
cool.
Really well.
Yes,
like, clever.
It's like Britney Spears 1999.
Okay, then I guess I'm gonna write that.
Definitely let us read it before you send it.
Yeah. I feel like Kevin never gets a chance to really go out with girls or really talk to them or meet them or anything, so I love that he's asking his advice because it means that he really cares about having a good impression on this girl, and that just means a lot, you know?
God, this is so cute.
Actually, I'm okay with you.
I like the LOL.
Yeah.
Don't worry, Kevin, I got you.
Thank you. I'm serious, I feel like going to school like stunted my growth in this stuff. Because I just like didn't care or do this at all. So like practicing cello and like studying for medical school.
And I guess smiling.
Not winking.
Really?
I feel like even that's still too forward. Like,
no, right? Because a smiley is like cute. Like a winky would be like anyone.
Smiley's cute. Okay. This is good.
This is very nerve-wracking.
That smiley face is just too damn forward.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, for sure.
You can send it.
Ready?
By the end of the story, you're gonna have a girlfriend, Kevin.
No, at least like a date, though.
That'd be awesome.
Can't.
Do you not have faith in his ability?
I do have faith in his abilities, but I don't want him to rush it. It shouldn't be a goal to like get a girlfriend.
That's true.
A goal to meet someone. And
facts. Kirstie.
Yes. Right.
Very smart.
I have gifts for all of you.
Thank God.
Oh.
God, to see them at the Mall of America, that'd be such a trip.
Oh my God, the new ears.
Oh, shit.
The best news.
I am so excited to see them.
I feel like the whole world would be like, why are they so excited about getting those new in-ears? But it is Christmas morning for an acapella group. They're called Clear Tune Monitors, and you can hear all the frequencies, and I can hear Mitch over here, and I can hear Kirstie over here, and it just makes it so easy to tune and so easy to sing.
Oh my gosh, the logo looks so good. The KO's on it.
Oh!
You're gonna be glowing on stage.
I know. So the trio, we all got Swarovski ones. Because we all want to sparkle on stage.
That's really pretty. The sparkles are really pretty.
That was a great surprise.
That was a very good surprise.
They fit in here too, like better.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, they fit in your ear.
There you go. Oh my God, I can't wait.
Thank you.
The simple joys in life.
So I put the ears in and I hold up my phone to like look at them and see how they look in my ears, and they look so cute. Like, I love my color choice.
Welcome.
Of course they're Swarovski or Swarovski. There we go. That's how you say it.
When we have days off, we don't really have that much time to go do something crazy. So we couldn't really ski, or we couldn't snowboard. But I had always heard of this thing called snow tubing, where you just fly down a hill of snow, and it's really easy and really fun. And so we got a group of people together and we went snow
very
tubing.
Hard to get hurt while you're tubing as well.
So I'm going down this hill and I'm thinking, I am so afraid I'm going to fall and die, and I'm screaming like a little girl. Big black man screaming like a little girl. What do you know about it?
Yeah, where is Kevin from? Is he used to the snow? Or is he another southern person like Trio?
I always have to make things competitive, so instead of just sliding down the hill for fun, I was like, you guys, let's do like 3-on-3.
When you gotta race, when you do. It makes it so much more fun.
So it's the last run of the night, and it's Kevin versus me, and I am going to win. So bring it on, Kevo.
Esther, you have to stay on your mark and set. Last night, I had a dream about
you. In this dream, I'm dancing right beside you. Oh my god, Kevin's got him! Just a little bit of
fun, we were dancing all. And that's what we call victory!
Oh, never mind!
Second place goes to Kevin, Alicia. First place goes to... yours truly, Scott Hoying, everybody. Stop it, you guys. No, really.
Competition just
it's
makes
so
things
fun
way
going
more
going down the slopes, hanging out with some of my best friends, you know, just bonding.
Oh my god, that was an intense day.
Oh, how fun. You know, I haven't thought about tubing in a long time. We used to do that quite a bit when we were kids. It was like the one wintertime activity that I enjoyed because it was just sitting down. I didn't have to learn how to do anything. I didn't have to learn how to ski or learn how to snowboard or learn how to skate. Like, it was just, nope, sit down in this tube and let gravity work. And that is my kind of winter activity.
So what happened to Kevin and the woman that he was talking to? Like, I need answers. I crave answers. Because they went from pretty much just being in Minneapolis to a shot of a venue that I know for sure is not in the Twin Cities. So I hope Kevin found love in Minnesota. Like, that's just so damn cute. And really, if you have to pick a Midwestern state, you really cannot pick a better one than Minnesota. I mean, maybe Illinois, but I don't even know if I necessarily count them. They're like their own spot. But the whole two forward whole conversation with Kevin and the rest of Pentatonix, that was adorable. That was so damn cute. Like, whenever I think Kevin, I obviously think, oh, master beatboxer, incredible cellist, crazy smart, you know, going to med school or accepted to med school. But he really does bring up a good point. Like, he never really had a chance to talk to women because he was always practicing the cello or studying or working on getting into med school. Not beatboxing, though. That's just something he learned to do for Pentatonix, I think. I don't know if I'm wrong. Definitely let me know there. But I would love to know what happened. And if anybody out there happens to be the woman that he matched with and the whole extra credit thing, feel free to let me know that down in the comments, because that is fucking adorable. That is so damn cute. And the tubing actually looked so fun that it made me almost forget just how bitterly cold winter is. really anywhere that it snows. It's awful. It is absolutely horrible. But watching the tubing, like if you'll notice, when they were going up the hill, they just hooked their tube onto like a rope and that pulled them up. Well, when I was a kid, we didn't have that hook. It was just a rope and you grabbed onto it with your hands. And I was maybe 7 or 8 years old and I was almost at the top of the hill. It was a very, very busy day. And my mittens slipped or something happened and I lost grip of the rope and I just went all the way down the hill hitting every single other person that was getting lifted up the hill. It was fucking chaos. And it's still something that I am embarrassed about to this day. So thank you, Pentatonix, for bringing all those memories flooding back. But yeah, this was so much fun. This was a grand time. So yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed it as much as me. And I will see you all in episode 8 next week. Thank you.